What's up, guys? Welcome back to Maestro Vapes. Today, I wanted to shoot a short video just about an introduction to cloud chasing, okay? Because when I started cloud chasing, I guess I'm a cloud chaser. I don't really like to refer to myself as that because when I think cloud chaser, I always think of like some 20-year-old kid who's building coils beyond their means, you know? And that's the way that the vaping community kind of sees it. And I'm a dude who's like 38 years old, all right? Like, I'm an old dude pushing clouds. But when I got into it, I didn't get into it to push clouds and fog out my living room. I got into it because I wanted a better vape and I wanted a warmer vape. That's what I wanted. When I was vaping stuff like Vivi Novas and Top Coil Clearos, I was getting a warmer vape from them, and that's what I dug. But there were Pro Tanks coming out and stuff like that that were bottom coil, and they weren't very warm, okay? So I started building my own coils. Now, let me take a step into the future and we'll go back to the past, okay? A lot of people comment on my videos and say stuff like, hey dude, I'm just getting into building coils and I want to build a 20 gauge dual coil build. Dude, you're going too far. Or I've got comments where people are like, hey man, I did the build that you did and my mod is getting hot. What am I doing wrong? Okay man, if you don't know what's going on and you're building below a point of an ohm, you shouldn't be doing it. You know, you shouldn't be doing it because the fun is in the journey. You know, when I started building coils, I was building coils that were like 2 ohms and 1.2 ohms was like low for me. That was like my low when I was vaping them on regulated mods and I was doing like 1.2 to 1.5 ohm builds. That's what I liked. I started building with like 32 gauge, 30 gauge, 28 gauge nichrome wire, and then I kind of went to Canthal. And I dug Canthal and I was doing 28 gauge builds. Then I started doing like twisted 28 gauge builds. I was doing 28 gauge and 0.5 ribbon tigers. And I was learning like the art of it. And that's what I liked. So I built a lot of those kind of like artsy kind of coils before I even went to 26 gauge. And it seems like now people want to run before they even crawl or walk, you know, which kind of weirds me out, you know, because you're missing out on that journey and that's the fun part, you know. But here it is, like when I went to 26 gauge, I was getting good vapes. When I went to 24 gauge, I got phenomenal vapes. And once I got to like 24 gauge, I started doing parallel stuff and I was growing with it. I was becoming a better builder, but I vented batteries. Like at that point, I vented batteries. And I understood what could go wrong. You know, I was using an ohm reader for everything. Like I was using an ohm tester for everything to make sure that I didn't have shorts. And that's really, really important, okay? If you don't have an ohm reader and you're building and you're new to building, stop building, you know? Because it's really important to know what's going on. And it's not just to read what the resistance is, but it's to read if there's something going on. Like if your resistance is fluctuating really hard, you have a short. Like you have a short, you need to tighten a connection, or if you're using like G-plat or something like that, you fried one of your wires and it's just like there's a break in it or something, you know? So you gotta go back to the drawing boards and fix it or rebuild or whatever, but you want a nice solid reading on your ohm reader. That's, you know, one of the most important things. Another good thing to have is to have an Ohm's Law calculator. Okay, you can get them on your phones, you can get them on your laptop, you can find them wherever, just search Ohm's Law calculator. And that's gonna tell you, a lot of times what I do is, I'll build a coil and I'll figure out what the resistance is. Okay, so let's say it's, you know, 0.25 ohm, right? And then I could put in like what I think that my mech is gonna be pushing out at. Now, I know a lot of the times when I put a load onto my battery, like my battery's 4.2-ish, 4.16 to 4.2 on a fresh charge, there's a little bit of a voltage drop from my mod. So usually when I try to figure out what the amp limit is, what the amps are reading at, the drain is going to be on my battery, I'll put in 4 or 4.1 volts, okay, if that makes any sense. So I'll have my resistance in there, you know, 0.25 ohms, and then I'll put in 4.1 or 4 volts. And then I do calculate, and it'll tell me, okay, this is what the amp drain is going to be on your battery. This is what the wattage works out to. And it helps you to learn. Like, it helps you to grow as a builder. And I think that's really important. And those are steps that people are just, you know, not doing at all. And really, you should. You should understand Ohm's Law a little bit. Especially if you're getting into low resistances. Understand it, you know. And look into your batteries. The batteries that you're using. There's good ones out there to use, you know. But you're not going to want to use, like, a Samsung 29, you know, if you could find a Samsung 25R, it's a great low resistance battery. If you could find Sony VTCs, they're great low resistance batteries. If you could find the Imran batteries, Imran has like 38 amp batteries. They're good batteries. Okay. So check those out, you know, because if you're building low resistances on a 10 amp battery, and you're pushing it beyond 10 amps, your mod is going to get hot. You're going to experience possible venting, which I did when I started building. I was building, you know, like 0.7s and 0.8s when I was venting batteries. But since that, I learned about it. And I didn't vent batteries. And now it's, I haven't vented a battery in probably, I don't know, at least 6 or 7 months. Okay. And if you have that, like, I've seen videos of people, there was like a dude in the UK and he was building like 10 strand twisted 24 gauge and he had a towel around his mod and he's firing it because his mod is getting so hot that he can't even hold on to it with his flesh. You know, like, if that is happening, take a step back, okay? Because you got to crawl before you walk. Just like I said, you know, you got to crawl before you walk and you don't want to miss out on the journey, you know? And like I said earlier, I was building coils and having fun with it. And I was trying to get a warmer, better vape that I liked. It was never about cloud chasing for me. It was just getting that warm vape that I liked, you know? They say taste is subjective in juice. So when people do juice reviews, they're like, taste is subjective. You know, what I like, you might not like, okay? And it's the same thing for building, you know? People are saying, oh, well, if you build it this low, it's going to get super hot and it burns off the flavor. But that taste is subjective, you know? And for me, I dig it. Like, I dig a warm vape and I can still get good flavor. I can still get good flavor. So there's that. Another thing that you're going to want to get into is airflow. Okay, if you're building low resistances and you don't have the airflow to match up to your build, it's going to be a horrible vape. It's going to be a horrible vape. Like, let's look at this guy. This is the Hobo. Hobo's got these slots, and they're decent slots, but really, they're pretty small. Like, you don't cloud chase on this Addy. This Addy can blow decent clouds, but you can't put, like, a 0.08 build in here. Because it's just going to be tremendously hot and taste brutal. Okay, so if you have airflow to match it, it's going to get better. So let's look at this top cap. This is the Captain cap. It's got like 4 mil plus holes in it. Tons of airflow in there. A lot of times there's like airflow patterns like the Mutation X has. I've drilled out a lot of stuff to kind of mimic the way the Mutation X was before the Mutation X even came out. And you're going to need that. You're going to need that when you're building low. And that's going to help you blow clouds too, if that's what you're after. You know, but if you've never built coils or you've built 28 gauge canthal build, stuff like that, don't try and go to 22. You know, enjoy it. And the same thing goes for people who work in shops and stuff like that. I've gone to shops where there was some dude vaping a Nautilus, and it's like a 1.6 ohm coil, and then he wants to get into Max, or she wants to get into Max, and they build them like a 0.2 ohm coil, yes, it's going to be a tremendously different vape. And maybe they love it, and they're like, oh, now I can do that. It kind of freaks me out. Like, it kind of worries me a little bit, because there's a lot of steps that you could take in between there, you know? So if somebody is building, or if somebody's vaping a coil, it's like 1.6 ohm, you could build them a 1 ohm coil, which would be well within the limits of any 10 amp battery, and they're gonna dig it. Like, they are gonna dig it, okay? So know your audience, know your customer, you know? That's one thing. So if you work in a shop, you're building people coils, know what they're vaping, you know? Don't build them what you want, you know? I've had people reach out to me and say, hey dude, I like your 0.08 coil, can you build me one? And it's like, I don't even reply to a lot of those, because I feel like if you can't build it for yourself, and you shouldn't be vaping it, you know what I mean? Like, it's cool, you'd get it, you could blow clouds, but what happens when, you know, one of your Phillips screws on your Addy backs out a little bit and you're getting a short, and you don't know why there's a problem, or why your mod's getting hot, or why your battery's shorting? Like, you need to learn that. And it's beautiful, man. Like, building coils is a beautiful thing. Like, and we got to remember, the reason why I build coils and I do what I do is to keep my mind off smoking, you know? Like, when I started vaping, I still wanted to smoke. Like, I dug vaping a lot, but I still kind of wanted to smoke. So building coils helped me get over that. Like, it kept me occupied so that I didn't think about it and I didn't smoke. And it was like the most beautiful thing that could have happened to me. And it could be for you as well. So just, you know, take your time and don't worry about what your friends are doing or what somebody else tells you you should be doing. Like, or me, like, I shoot these videos because I try and help people, because I know that people are gonna do what they're gonna do no matter what. Like, if you have your heart set on building a 22 gauge parallel coil, you're gonna do it, but hopefully there's somebody there to help you, and that's why I do what I do, you know? So I don't know, I'm kind of babbling on here, but a couple of the things you want to know or want to have for sure is watch a lot of videos, read a lot of articles, go on forums and talk to people. There's people building every day talking about builds, and they will help you. They will definitely help you. So do that. But, you know, grow with it. You know, grow with it and have a good time. You know, you don't have to do what I do because I do it. You know, like, fuck me. Fuck your buddy who fucking thinks he's a cloud chaser. You know what I mean? Do what you like and enjoy it. If you're vaping like a one, like even with these new sub tanks and the Atlantis coming out, you can get a 0.5 ohm build. That's a pretty good build, but you know, but it's kind of weird because everybody starts vaping and they start vaping in an ego or whatever. And then they want to start blowing clouds. Like, that's, It's a weird transition, you know, and I don't understand it completely, because when I started vaping, cloud chasing wasn't huge, you know, it wasn't what it was, you know. In 2013, cloud chasing was kind of, you know, starting up, and then in 2014, all this year, it just blew out of proportion, you know. And I don't know, I guess I was a cloud chaser and whatever, but you know, crawl before you walk, you know, and just have fun. Like, have fun, have good vapes in there, because you might not like cloud chasing and hot vapes. Once you get down to it and you build it and you have it, you might just go, oh, this sucks. And then you start smoking again, you know? But if you go through the steps and you build, you know, 0.8s and 0.7s and 0.6s, and you're learning about batteries and Ohm's law and you know, you might find something along the way that you like, you know, in between. And you might end up at like 0.3 ohm builds and be really happy with it. You know, be really, really happy with it. So there's that. Copper mods. Copper mods have great conductivity, so you're going to see them a lot. You know, a lot of cloud chasers use copper mods because they work well for sub-ohm builds, okay? If you're using a stainless mod, I've used some good ones, but I've also used some ones where the threading gets burning hot, scorches you, like to a point where it's not just like hot to the touch, but it just like melts your hand is immediately. Like you just get this weird burn and feel it after it's already burnt. Kind of like touching the element on your stove, you know? So be careful with that. Get a decent mod. There's some good box mods people are making too, like parallel battery box mods that you'd be pretty happy with. I'm just a mech guy. I like 20 or 18650. There's a couple of 26650 mods that I like. 26650 is pretty decent. The amp limits are typically higher on 26650, so you could do those builds a little bit safer. But in the same comment, like, I haven't found a perfect 26650 battery yet. You know, there's nothing that compares to an 18650 with a decent internal resistance, you know? And that's something else you could look up too while you're at it, you know, internal resistance of batteries. But there's a lot that goes into it, and just learn about it. You know, when I learned about it, it was all about Ohm's law, understanding the batteries that I used, different types of metals and alloys that we're using for our mods, and take a step back and look at your mod and understand how it works. You know, if you're using a mech, understand how it works. And your batteries can only go in one way, okay? Don't put your batteries in upside down, okay? So let's say, you know, the top of your mod is your atomizer. Make sure that positive end is making contact with it, and not the other way around, because a lot of people, and I'm sure if you work in a vape shop, seen a lot of people come in with their batteries upside down, okay? Battery goes right side up, positive to your atomizer, negative goes to your firing switch, and that's it, you know? Play safe, okay? Because, you know, cloud chasing is a very small part of vaping, you know? And I don't want to see it get frowned upon because people are venting batteries and having issues with their mods, you know? So there's that. That's it, man. I just wanted to shoot this quick video to kind of help some people out, okay? If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. And if you're commenting and you know the answer, comment on somebody else's comment, you know? But there's a lot of ignorance in vaping, you know, because it is a new thing. Like, vaping is relatively new. I don't care how long you vape for, if it's been, you know, 1 month or 1 year or 5 years, whatever it is. But it's relatively new. So when there's something new, there's a lot of ignorance, you know, and a lot of people hear something from someone or read something on the internet and believe it to be true and then share it with 100 people. And then that becomes truth. And we don't need that, you know? Hopefully this helped you out a bit. All the stuff that I said is from my own personal experiences building low resistance for, you know, probably a year I've built pretty low, you know? So there's that. Play safe, my friends. Like I always say, guys, butt out, vape up, and breathe easy. Know your limits and vape within it. And you, my friend, are going to have a stellar day. All right, that's all I got today. Have a good one, guys.